As many of you know, I really do like fountain pens. For me, a good fountain pen is just such a pleasure to use. Many of you may think that pens are the only thing I use to write with. If you're talking about letters and notes, I'd say you are correct. If you've never written by hand in a journal or a diary, your thoughts on things, or if you've never penned a thoughtful letter to a friend or a relative, or even a passionate note to a lover, all I can say is that you don't know what you're missing. But then there's the type of writing that, because the finished document has to be in a digital format for school or work, modern technology is a better choice than a pen. Now, some of you may just have fallen out of your chair having heard me say that. And for those of you that are still stuck in 1982, like Uncle Rico, I'm not talking about an electric typewriter. I'm talking about the modern computer word processor, with all its features like spell check, thesaurus, countless fonts, formatting, and ability to insert pictures, graphs. Because never having to use whiteout on the next to last line of a typed document is worth a computer's weight in gold. But there are times when using your desktop or laptop computer can actually hinder your ability to write. I've heard many an author say that because of the internet and email, a computer can end up being nothing more than an expensive distraction that keeps a writer from being productive. And I'm sure many of you would agree. And that is exactly why I have one of these. It's called the AlphaSmart NEO, and it's made by Renaissance Learning. And Renaissance Learning is headquartered in Wisconsin Rapids, Wisconsin. Unless they've recently moved. Now, many of you may remember these from grade school because they were developed and marketed, marketed for teaching kids to read, write, and type. Now, there are many things that make this device appealing to the writer. It's light. It weighs less than most computer keyboards. So it's highly portable. It doesn't radiate any heat when you use it, so therefore it's comfortable to use it when you're sitting on a train or on a park bench or even on a beach towel. It uses three AA batteries. And the batteries last for about 700 hours, which is over a year if you use this device for 2 hours a day. When you press the on button, it comes on instantly and it's ready to use with no waiting. And the cursor even goes to the last word that you typed so that you can easily pick up where you left off. We can hold hundreds and hundreds of typed pages. I hear my dog asking to come in, so I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Now, like I said, it can hold hundreds of typed pages, but it also has 8 file slots so that you can keep individual chapters or projects separate. Keep them separated. Here's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, what I just typed is in file slot number 8. If I press file 1, it goes to an empty file. Now, if I go back to file 8, what I've typed in file 1 will stay there. So let's go back to file 1. But the number one reason that this device appeals to me is because it's a word processor and nothing more. No internet, no email, and that means no distractions. This is the perfect tool for banging out that first draft of your article or your essay or your novel. And that's what I'm currently using it for. With this device, I can go anywhere to find inspiration. Whether it be on a boat on a still mountain lake, or the coffee shop down the street. Because there's no internet, no email, I can actually form sentence after sentence, paragraph after paragraph, and page after page without being sidetracked by the tempter known as the internet. Some of the features of this device, besides having the ability to store 8 different projects or chapters, it has a lot of the same stuff you'd find on a PC. Like, you can highlight a word, hold the shift key down and arrow. Control copy will copy that word. Then you can paste it somewhere else, simply by Control V. I can clear the file just by hitting Clear File. And it wants me to confirm yes, so I hit Y. I can start all over. And really, it's pretty basic. I can open up maybe, let's see if I can find a file that I've already have a project going. If I hit Control W, it tells me that in this file I have 1,509 words, 3.9 pages, 44 paragraphs, and 8,070 characters. And I think this 15% means that this file slot is 15% full. So let me go to another file. Okay, file 6 has 986 words, 2.5 pages, 28 paragraphs, and 5,117 characters. You hit escape to get out of that. You know, I think we're all used to the escape button being up here in the top left corner, but on this device it's down here next to the space bar. Now on the back side, there's a place to plug a USB printer into it. And here's a place to plug it into your computer so that you can transfer what you typed over onto your computer. If you need some AC power for some reason, you can plug an AC adapter into at this point. And this connection, I think, is for some kind of wireless or infrared transmitter. I don't use this feature, so I didn't really even read the manual on that. And on the back of it, there's actually directions on how to use it and how to transfer your text over to your computer. And here's a table of different commands, hotkeys and stuff that you can use to do certain functions. I really think it's a great device. So much so that I wished I had two of them. Or let me qualify that statement by saying I used to wish that I had two of them. Teacher friend had one of these in the classroom. And for whatever reason, chose not to use it. So now I am in possession of it. Here's a USB cable for transmitting your text to the computer. Here's some kind of management software. Here's documentation. I notice this model is the NEO 2, which is I think it's their latest model. The one that I was showing you a minute ago was just a regular NEO 1, I guess. This is a NEO 2. And you can tell this was marketed to the schools. This is NEO 2. The only laptop designed for classrooms. The Some of the things you can do with it are keyboarding practice, on-the-fly quizzes, formative assessments, AR quizzes, daily math practice, math facts practice, classroom technology integration. Wireless file transfer. Text-to-speech. All sorts of stuff. Bet you didn't know this would turn into an unboxing video. As you can see, it looks exactly like this one. Let me get some batteries and we'll put them in and power this thing up. Battery cover just slides out like this. Optional battery door security screw. And I think I'll use the little screw. That might keep me from someday losing the battery cover. And it looks just like the other one. Now some of you may be thinking, well, isn't it overkill to have two of these? Well, maybe. Now I have the ability to keep one at another location that I've been wanting to do. So no matter which location I'm at, I'll have one of these available. Let me reposition the camera and I'll show you how to transfer the text that you type onto the computer. Now these are the steps that you need to take to transfer the text from the Neo to the computer. The first thing you need to do is open up your word processor that you have on your computer. In my case, I use Microsoft Word and I have a blank document open. The next thing you want to do is turn the Neo on and select the file that you want to transfer to the computer. Remember, you have 8 possibilities, 1 through 8, and I'm going to select 2. And now, take the USB cable with one end connected to your computer and take the other end and plug it into the Neo. Now when I press this button that says send, it'll send everything that's in file number 2 to the blank Word document that I have open on my computer. So on the count of 3, I'll press the send button on the Neo. 1, 2, 3. And as you can see, it's copying to the open Word document the text that I had in file number 2. Obviously, it's not very fast, but that's okay. And right here it tells you what percentage you have transferred. At this point, I've transferred almost 25% of the document. Yes, there's nothing quick about it. So you can actually start the file transfer and then make yourself a cup of coffee or something. Or watch a sitcom, take a bath, I don't know. And it's at about 62%. So once I get everything transferred over onto the computer, then I can use Microsoft Word's the different features of it to edit my document, tweak it just the way I want it. Right now it's just a first draft. There's a lot of things that need to be changed. But the whole point was just to arrange my thoughts into something that was workable. So the Neo is perfect for that. Just get the rough idea out there, transfer it onto your computer, and then tweak it. So it finished transferring the text from the Neo to the computer. And if I hold the command key and choose another file, I can go ahead and transfer another file if I so choose. And if I hit the send button, it'll send file number 4. But at this point, I'm sure everyone gets the picture. So that concludes this video. And if you categorize yourself as a distracted writer because you're trying to write using a computer that has Facebook and YouTube and email on it, and you just can't force yourself to focus long enough to get that first draft finished, I strongly suggest picking up one of these AlphaSmart NEOs. That way you can walk away from the computer, sit out in a shade on a blanket under a tree in your pickup truck. It doesn't matter, just anywhere where you're not distracted by the internet, and get that first draft finished. Get it done. Get it onto your computer, and then you can tweak it. I hope you liked the video, and I hope you wasn't bored with it. Thanks for watching.